A coffee maker is the most important thing that we need to be able to power from a mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical system because, let's be honest, without coffee, nothing else we would need to power really matters.
This drink, I like it.
I know, it's great, right?
Another!
But how much power does a coffee maker actually use to brew a pot of coffee? Well, that's exactly what I'm going to teach you how to calculate here in lesson number one of this electrical system sizing playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, the methods of estimating power usage that I'm going to teach you will work for many other appliances like induction cooktops, blenders, air fryers, and a lot more. So if you keep an open mind and think critically, you'll be able to apply this information to your own specific project. Now, last thing before we get started, I put some important information about this academy, some additional resources, and some prerequisite information related to this video down in the pinned comment below. So be sure to scroll down and check it out. Let's get started. So how much power does a coffee maker actually use? The easy method. Now back in lesson 1.3 of this academy, I taught you how to calculate watt hours given watts and minutes, and that's exactly what we're going to be using here. First, we need to know how many watts the coffee maker takes to operate. Now if you already have the coffee maker that you want to use, this will be listed on the spec sticker somewhere on the coffee maker or in the user manual. Now, alternatively, you could look up the make and model of your coffee maker on Google, and you should just be able to find out how many watts it uses if you look around a little bit. Also, remember from lesson 1.3 that if your appliance tells you how many amps it uses, you can convert from amps to watts by multiplying the amps of the device by the voltage of the source to get the operating watts of the device. Now our coffee maker uses 1550 watts when it is actively brewing, which is the first part of the equation. How long does it take to brew a pot of coffee? So that took 5 minutes and 54 seconds. Which I'm just going to round up to 6 minutes so that I don't have to deal with fractions of minutes. And we can just plug that into our equation of watt hours equals watts times minutes divided by 60 from earlier. Now, 1550 watts times 6 minutes divided by 60 minutes per hour gives us 155 watt hours to brew this pot of coffee. Once we have watt hours, we can convert them into amp hours in order to size our battery bank and solar array, but we're going to cover that more in depth later in this academy once we cover the full power audit tutorial at the end of this playlist, so consider subscribing. Once the coffee maker finishes brewing, it actually enters a low power mode for a period of time after brewing to keep the coffee warm. But unfortunately, with the information that we have at the moment, there's no way to estimate how much additional power the keep warm function will use. But keep watching and I'll show you how to figure it out. But before we move on, I want to hear from you. After watching this video, I'd love for you to test out your own coffee maker and put the results down in the video description below. Let me know what make and model of coffee maker that you're using, its wattage, how long a brew cycle is, and how many watt hours it requires for a brew cycle. I'm trying to build out a database of what kind of power usage various devices use, and teamwork makes the dream work, so help me out and leave your results down in the comments below. How much power does a coffee maker use? A more precise method. So I bought some of these AC power meters on Amazon for about 15 bucks. And although it takes just a little bit longer than just doing math, it's really precise and gives a lot more detail into how much power is flowing through the meter at any given time. Plus, it keeps a running total of how much power has gone through the meter, which can be reset for accurate reporting. So this meter shows me that when the coffee maker was brewing, it was operating at just a bit over its rated wattage, and it also kept a tally of how much power has been used since it was last reset right before brewing this pot of coffee. And yesterday, I brewed a pot of coffee and also let it go through its entire keep warm cycle, and here are the results. 1569 watts for 5 minutes and 54 seconds resulted in 0.14 kilowatt hours being used, or 140 watt hours, which is pretty close to our calculations from earlier. So how much power does a coffee maker's keep warm cycle use? So during the 1 hour and 10 minute keep warm cycle, the coffee maker cycled on and off using anywhere from 0 to 100 watts, and our energy meter tells us that it used 0.85 kilowatt hours or 85 watt hours through that keep warm cycle. For context, 225 watt hours pulled from a 12 volt battery bank would be a loss of 18.75 amp hours or 18.75% being drawn from a 100 amp hour battery per pot of coffee brewed, not counting any kind of inverter efficiency losses. Pro tip, avoid the coffee maker's keep warm cycle. So when Steph and I were living in our van full time, we actually had a coffee maker that had an insulated pot. So once the cycle was done, the coffee maker just turned off, and the insulated pot kept the coffee warm for hours, which sort of gets rid of the keep warm cycle altogether. So something to consider there. Now you should have a pretty good idea of how to calculate the power used by a coffee maker for your mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical system. And you can use these principles to figure out the power usage of many other items like air fryers, instant pots, blenders, and much more. The quick and dirty method of using the listed device wattage multiplied by the time used is good, but picking up an AC meter like this for precise measurements is a great tool to have in your belt. Now, we will refer back to this video later in this academy when we discuss full power audits, so be sure to bookmark it for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher. Before we move over to the next lesson in this playlist, be sure to tell me how much power you've measured your coffee maker to use down in the comment section below. In the next lesson, I'm going to teach you how to determine the power required for a cell phone. So click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there. It takes forever when you're just like twiddling your thumbs, like waiting for it.
I mean, you can hear it from over here. He swallows so loud.